What the heck? Hello?
Jorila den Shohen. Shujara nem Jogen. Veto, Veto.
Yeah, he's busy, all right.
Veto. Shijara nem Lohem Sharath. She showed me. She showed me. She showed me all.
Who? What are you talking about? Who showed you what?
She. The temple.
She led me next through the window of time.
And I saw it. All of it.
The high ones, the light, the
burnt flesh everywhere.
Burnt flesh?
Yes, because of the light. It burns us from within. I saw them, men, women and children. They were ablaze like the sun. So bright and... why did you show me? Why? No one should have to see something like that. No one.
Sorry I asked. I see you saw the High Ones?
Yes, and they're with us here and now, everywhere and always. And no matter what we do, we can't hide. Do you understand? We can't.
My sir, you're not yourself. Just calm down and we can...
No! Stay away from me!
You don't understand. You can't understand. She's so sad. So sad and so full of wrath because we chose to close our eyes rather than see.
Because she?
We refuse to understand.
Understand what? You're not making any sense.
That it's us. We are sin, don't you see? And there's only one way to end it.
What? No!
You're gonna kill me?
Put that away, this is
madness! Kill yourself?
Madness! What we do is madness! This is the only way to break the cycle. One glance was enough to understand her suffering. To understand that there's no other solution than ultimate death. One day, you will understand that. You too, fleshless one.
They're gonna kill himself.
And now, we have to die. It won't change much. But maybe it will make her just a little happier.
Oh.
Forgive me.
What? I'm not fighting you, Constantine. Okay, maybe I am fighting him.
Just die.
You gotta kill us all? What the hell? Hold on a second. I can't kill him.
But why?
Oh my God. No.
That was... What the heck?
He's really dead?
Why, by the wise hermit, would he do that? His eyes... I've never seen anything like that.
Were they red? Was it the red madness? Maybe the High Ones took control of him?
You mean he was possessed? I don't know. I always thought the possessed have a red shimmer in their eyes when it gets bad. He didn't.
No, he didn't.
And what was that talk about making her happy? Did he mean the temple? My. This doesn't get better. We'll need to tell the Order about it. Now, let's push on. At least we should find this train. We owe Firespark that much.
So sad. I had no idea any of this was gonna happen. Shouldn't we at least bury him?
Yeah, you're right. Come on, let's find a shovel. Or something like that.
I have a shovel. What do we make, a cairn?
What now?
Guess so. My Arbiah had stayed this whole time we were burying him. And that's it. I guess I reminded him. Let's push on. We need to find the Undertrain.
Such chaos.
Hope I don't lose you too, Jaspar. Yeah, you lead the way for once.
You hear that? Waves.
Yep, there's water down there. Poor Constantine, I'm gonna miss him.
Wait, I know that smell. Stay here.
Apparently I can't move, so yeah. That smell.
Where did we find Yarrow's wife?
Sorry?
Yarrow's companion. Where did we find her coffin? Please, just do me a favor and answer. Just do it.
You were there. In his father's house in the cellar.
Then it really is you.
Oh. Who else would I be?
Good question. Best you take a look for yourself. I'll wait here.
As he walks away. I'll wait here. Well, you could have warned me. We have dead versions of ourselves. Serious? Is this the guy from the dream? I don't remember his name. Well, at least we got muscle meat. Yeah, that... You could have warned me.
So, any explanations?
How the hell should I know? None.
It must be some kind of illusion. A mirage, created by this bloody temple. Or maybe even the High Ones. Yes, of course, that must be it. They're trying to confuse us. By the Wise Hermit, they'll do just about anything, won't they? This is just... wrong. This is crazy.
Ugh. Oh.
Well, working with you is definitely an experience, to say the least. We should push
on.
Find that stupid train. I just want to get out of this place as quickly as possible.
Sirius was the one that we were on the ship with, isn't he? It's the one we got tied to and thrown overboard. I wonder if this Undertrain is even real. Oh. Lower floors, okay. Well, we are going under. Where'd he go? Killed my Orbaya? Damn. He hits pretty hard. I can't hold too many more of these warhammers. Where'd the other one go? He's down there. What, did he sneak past these things? Oh. 36 coins. My troubles. Gives us a lot back. That's awesome. I figure I can't miss the thing. But I know there was two of them. I don't know what happened to the other one. Anything down here? Nope. Oh, this is the car. I just noticed it was here. Oh, he fell all the way down there. I see him now. Surprised anything could knock him that far back.
Bullseye. Water spared the train. It's beautiful in a way, don't you think?
Yeah.
I bet every arcanist would give his left hand to look at it. And we're about to use it. Only thing left to do now is find out how. Seems to me that we first have to open this gate and reactivate the mechanism that powers this place. I'll take a look around. Try and find something that lets us open the gate.
Okay. Switch your levers.
This is crazy.
Got just good crazy stuff here. Rancid sheep, health potion, standard mana. Ah, I see. Here's another. Maybe two on the other side. Probably, oh, one here. I cannot use this while in combat, okay. Who are we in combat with? Oh. Dead. Oh, I can go in now? Roger. I don't know why I can't pull a lever when I'm in combat. I hear skeletons. I can't reach that far. It felt like someone turned another lever just then. Oh, I couldn't even see you, it's so dark. Hiding in the dark. Back here. Thought he was. Ah, here we are. That's the kind of frustrating to keep interrupting me turning levers. That'll fill me up. So that one we've done already. Let me just... No. hard to tell which ones you've done. They just go back to the original position. There you go. All aboard, don't leave without me.
Go on inside and take a seat, okay? I'll see if I can get the train running somehow. It can't be too hard.
Wait on the bench. Ah. The subway. Huh. Very interesting. Nice beds. You are really getting in the way a lot today, Marius. Ah, take a load off.
Ta-da! Yes, I'm amazing. I know that. If being a merc doesn't work out in the long run, maybe I'll ask the Order to hire me as an expert on Pyrenean railways. But no guarantee this thing won't drive us right into the next abyss. Anyway, I guess even with this thing, it should be a while till we arrive. Let's make ourselves comfortable.
Okay. Very close? Okay.
Sorry for the drama back there at the house. I guess I just didn't know what to make of the situation.
Oh yeah, when you found my body, apparently, or a body that looked like mine. I wonder what you would have done if I hadn't known the answer. Killed me?
No idea. And please, save the subtle accusations, okay? If I reacted somewhat inappropriately, I'm sorry. But hey, I'm not the one whose corpse is lying around in some old ruin.
Well, that's my fault?
Sorry about that. I'm a little on edge right now. No offense intended.
Just a question.
If the High Ones were planning to confuse us, they definitely succeeded. We really should tell the Grand Master about this. And about what happened to Constantine.
Yeah.
Still, we can't allow this to get inside our heads too much. What matters right now is the mission.
Right.
And at least it stays exciting. Two daring adventurers who have gotten themselves into something they don't even remotely understand are plundering ancient ruins in search of treasure. Don't laugh, but this reminds me a little of my past, of my childhood.
Then you definitely had one strange childhood.
Save for the crazed mages and the mysterious bodies, of course. My sister and I, when we were young, we always used to go exploring the caves near our manor. Father always gave us a good scolding when he got wind of it. But of course, that didn't keep us from doing it again.
You have a sister? You didn't mention a sister.
Right. Because I never told you. Adila and I are not exactly close these days anyway. Probably because we lost our bond somehow after our father died.
Your father died? Prematurely, I take it?
Yes, he did. Together with my siblings. Actually, Adila and I are the only surviving Delverics. All the others were murdered.
Sorry to hear that.
No need to be. But I appreciate the thought, so thanks. In a sad way, a part of me is actually glad everything happened the way it did back then. It made me into a man, and it showed me what kind of characteristics have a tendency to drastically shorten one's life.
Such as?
Stubbornness. My father was a judge in the tribunal, you know. He was a hard man, who at least, after our mother died while giving birth to Adila, lived for only one thing. His principles. Justice knows no compromise. That was his great creed. No matter who stood before him in court, my father treated them all the same. Damien Delverick, the epitome of justice.
Wow. He had his principles. It sounds admirable, at least to me.
It does to most people.
Oh, he disliked
it. One day, the son of a highly regarded Archer Sublime stood before the 12 judges of the court, Valenzio Duran. He had murdered two whores, made them happy, as he called it, and it was obvious that he didn't feel so much as a hint of remorse. You know those kind of people. The ones who think that money and power entitle them to anything they want.
Yeah, I can imagine how this is gonna end. I didn't know that part.
Of course you can. 11 of the 12 judges voted for a verdict of not guilty, because they knew Valenzio's father was influential within the Relata. Only my father, of course, remained unshaken. 1 week later, our manor was robbed by 4 masked men who killed everyone. Servants, guards, my 2 older brothers, all of them.
Masked men.
Officially, they were bandits, who just happened to be running around with blades made of shadow steel. My sister and I only survived because we had snuck out for one of our expeditions. Ironic, isn't it?
It's horrible.
Horrible? None of this is horrible. It was the only logical consequence of my father's actions. And what good did it do in the end? None. As we speak, Valenzio's enjoying himself in some brothel, with 2 whores and a bowl of grapes. But you see, there's no point in being angry about this. And do you know why? Because this is just how the world works. There's no divine justice, no system through which it's decided who lives and who dies. There are decisions and there are consequences. That's it. This is also why there's absolutely no point in fighting for ideals, the greater good, or whatever else you want to call it. First of all, because no one will thank you for it, and second, because people are stupid. That's the one universal rule that there is to this world. No matter how much you try to accomplish something, in the end, stupid people will destroy all you've achieved with no more than a snap of their fingers. Fight for the moment, and the moment only. Because unlike everything else, you can be certain of its truth.
Well, people are stupid, though. Isn't that a little generalized?
Do me a favor and read the Chronicles of Vin, then ask me again.
I don't think I read that one. You're right. It was probably more about promoting his ideals than real justice.
Absolutely. If he had wanted to see this snob die so badly, there would have been other ways. Poison, an accident, a hired killer. Just a hint of common sense, that's all he would have needed. But, of course, none of that would have conformed with his sacred principles. Adila and I were still young when all this happened. A friendly family took us in, and my sister joined the Order of the Apothecary in the Frostcliff Mountains. But since then, we haven't been able to speak to one another. She raised a wall of ice around herself, so to speak, and fled into old family books and memories. But, anyway, enough about me. You're an orphan too, aren't you? How come? You never told me about that.
That's a long story. Where should I start?
You told me that the Creator's Temple in Ostian had something to do with it, but what exactly happened?
I guess I told him a long story.
Dreams. Yeah. I've had my share of nightmares, too. There was this one that plagued me for years. I'd be in some kind of hall, almost like a temple. Only that there were benches and aisles, like in a courtroom. My father sat on the judge's dais, but he was a corpse, and all the spectators and the jury looked like him. Anyway, there was this grotesque trial scene where he accused me of refusing to do my duty for them, and it always ended with his skin melting off like hot wax.
Damn.
Pretty messed up, I know. Eventually, the dream stopped, though. Someone helped me with that. But anyway, enough of this gloomy talk for now. We should get some rest. We've still got a long ride ahead of us. Good night.
Good night.
Rise and shine, fair lady. We have arrived. How'd you sleep?
Just par. I mean, Marius got unsummoned. How one feels after having discovered one's own corpse, the whole thing in the temple. I just can't get it out of my mind.
Well, for what it's worth, neither can I. Come on, let's take a look outside.
The lion's den. Regardless of all hurdles and bizarre events, Constantine's plan worked out. We arrived on Half Moon Isle without anybody noticing. Now we have to hide the silver plates in the Nermes' camp. Follow Jespar. I'm gonna make that next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.